Hi guys, my name is Rahul and I love the mountains. I also happen to love every single thing that comes along with it. Welcome back to episode number 3 of my Kedartal trek series. I'm about 10 minutes away. I am so happy to see you and I really hope that you've enjoyed the previous two episodes.
I am almost at a height of 14,500 feet.
In case you haven't, I am going to drop the link to them in the description box below. We reached there at about 2 o'clock, had a nice lunch, set up our tents, and without any further ado, let me take you back to the campsite.
It's about 5:30 in the evening. I have not had enough water. It's also the third day without a shower. I've got sunburn. My arms, my neck is red, like red, and all of it just burns. I have zero motivation to get out of my tent right now.
But you definitely should get out of your tent because you would never want to miss out on the snacks that are there for you.
Karan, what's for snack today?
And also, these tents are much warmer than your own tent because of the amount of people inside with you enjoying those snacks. You should also try to get into bed very soon.
Tomorrow morning is going to be very early. I think we'll be leaving at 6 o'clock for the summit.
Due to the altitude, sleeping becomes difficult. More or less, you are going to have a headache, and the only way to deal with it is going to be by sleeping. But then, since I decided to make a vlog out of this and I had a decent enough camera, there was something I decided to do at 12:30 a.m. And that something was trying my hand for the first time at night photography. And it was time for me to sleep after that because next day was brutal.
Good morning everyone. It's 5:10 right now. We have to leave very early. We have to leave in the next 40 minutes for the summit, that is Kedartal. Today is like the most important day, but it also seems like the most stressful because I couldn't sleep at all last night. I have a massive headache. I'm wearing about 3 layers right now on my upper body and 2 on my lower body, in addition to a liner, in addition to a sleeping bag. The only thing that's remaining is probably me getting a cold, so I hope that does not happen.
And it was finally that time for all of us to make that final push for the summit. And when you are in the mountains, you should be prepared for literally everything.
The most unexpected thing or the most beautiful thing that you can expect and want to have on top of a mountain is having snowfall. Finally, after having left on Sunday, 4 days, no shower, haven't brushed in 2 days, and I am finally at Kedartal. Every inconvenience that I have gone through in my sleeping bag, in the travel from Dehradun, made a heavy bag though. I think that's one place where I really messed up.
And somehow, I always remember all the moments that I've gone through when I'm on a trek, when I'm about to reach the summit, and when I am on the summit.
This is a very emotional moment for me. I think there is something that I cannot express in words, standing amidst the mountains. There's a very different kind of silence here that I cannot define. It's so much that you can hear your own heartbeat. Every year, a mountain trip is something that I yearn for because it's very, very helpful for me in a manner that It helps me discover myself at an emotional and a physical level.
And since I have already established what kind of a feeling you go through when you are at a summit, my request to you is to go for a mountain trek, if possible, a snow trek. And trust me, you are going to thank me perhaps for the rest of your life.
You may feel an amazing sense of achievement, but at the same time, you also feel how helpless you are. And I do not think that there's anything else but the mountains that can make you feel this way.
And from there, it was time for us to head back to the campsite, but all the good things were about to become a lot more better. I did not imagine nor anticipate a slide made of snow on my way back.
Finally, we've made it back to the campsite, and it was one exhaustive hike to the Kedartal and back. There's gonna be lunch now, which is going to be followed by snacks, which is going to be followed by dinner, which is going to be followed by sleep. Tomorrow morning, we leave back for Gangotri, so it's a direct 11 kilometer descent, and we've estimated about 8 hours of non-stop walk for that. So.
And drifting a bit off topic here, but I am a personal trainer by profession.
As I've said before, Karan, trek leader, has given me the whole and sole responsibility of taking cool down stretching.
I took everyone through some cool down stretching at 14,500 feet.
Happy, none of us.
He's been teaching me a lot of stretches, so I'm looking forward to learn more.
Yeah, chalo, awesome. Chalo. Thank you very much.
Alright!
Yeah, guys, come on!
All my ugly looking guys, let's go, let's do some stretches!
And the thing with mountains is that you never know what the weather is going to be in the next 30 minutes. And like I said, all the good things were about to become much better.
There was nothing more that I would have asked from this trek. Seeing the summit, seeing the frozen lake, seeing the snow-clad mountains was enough for me. And then this happened. It has started snowing at about, I think about an hour ago, the speed at which it has been snowing. And I'm just gonna turn around the camera and you're gonna see how beautiful it is everywhere. Our campsites are covered in snow. All of it is going to be like a white blanket. I can't wait to wake up to that view.
And obviously, such a random snowfall also has its downsides.
Us?
Yes?
To go.
It's pretty stiff.
Wow.
It's frozen.
Oh my god.
And that was a pair of his socks.
This is like a bird, do you see?
And you wouldn't want to be stepping out of your tent without a poncho during such a snowfall, because when that snow falls on you, it basically turns to water when you step inside your tent, and you do not want to be sleeping with wet clothes. We were pretty much chilling inside the tent until the next day, and it was time for us to head back to the base village, that is Gangotri.
So I'm about 1.5-2 hours away from Gangotri, and I think for this year, this is the first and the last time, no, not the first time, the last time that I'm going to get to have lunch in the forests.
I am finally back in Gangotri, back to civilization, and I'm very happy, very dirty,
But I don't think I'm gonna have the luxury to have a shower until tomorrow. Today's a Friday. I'm gonna head to Dehradun tomorrow evening. I am going to get to have a shower. Yeah, shower is of the essence here. That's why you're hearing that word a lot more from my mouth.
And with this, we wrap up episode number 3, which was the final episode in this series. So I'm heading back home today, and it breaks my heart because I am extremely sorry for all the shaky footages. But given that this was my first time, I assure you, I'm gonna do a lot more better the next time.
The trek was beautiful. I have no words to describe the experiences that I have gone through.
I am just going to go ahead and assume that you guys have really enjoyed all the episodes. So please go ahead, share this video, hit that like button and the bell icon. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do so.
I think my videos and pictures are gonna do justice to them.
And I am going to see you guys next Thursday with a very different kind of a mountain video.
And whatever I have taken back, it's going to stay with me through this year until I go to the mountains again.